Okay, in this little tutorial, I'm going to go over types of bonding in minerals. The first one that we're going to look at is ionic bonding. Ionic bonding is what happens between two different atoms that both have charges. When they have opposite charges, they're going to be attracted to each other, and so they stick together. One of the best examples to look at ionic bonding in minerals is looking at halite. We know that halite's chemical formula is NaCl, sodium chloride. And if we know a little bit about these two atoms, we can actually get an idea for how they actually bond together. Sodium, if we go and we start to look at it, sodium has 11 protons in its nucleus, and it's going to be balanced by 11 electrons in its outer valence shells. Chlorine, on the other hand, has 17 protons in its nucleus. Okay, so we're going to start just by looking at how the atom is arranged for sodium. So I'm going to write 11P plus, just as a so we remember that this is our sodium, and it's actually going to be inside of the nucleus because these are all the protons. Okay, all atoms have valence shells. When we look at the first valence shell, it's always filled to capacity when it has two electrons in it. I'm going to draw these electrons in yellow, just as big dots. Okay, so we use up two of our electrons in that first valence shell for our sodium. In the second valence shell, we can fill eight. Okay, it's going to be filled with eight electrons. So we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 electrons. Okay, remember we need to have 11 electrons to balance out the 11 protons in the nucleus. So we have one more valence shell, and it's going to have this one little electron hanging out. Okay, atoms want to be stable. When they have all of the locations on those valence shells filled, they're going to be actually very, very stable. In the case where they only have one or two, they're unstable, and the atom is actually going to start to give off these electrons, just kind of shoot them out of the valence shell, and then just be happy having only 10 electrons in this case. So this sodium is going to take this one little electron, and it's going to get rid of it. Okay, so we'll just draw him over here, floating out in space, and we're going to get rid of the fact that he was ever present. And now we have a very happy sodium. But now when we look at it, we have 11 protons. So we have 11 positive charges, and we have 10, I'm going to write E minus for negative charges, our electrons. If we look at this, how it balances out, we have one more positive charge than negative charges. So this whole thing is now positively charged. Okay. When we take a look at chlorine, it's going to be a little bit bigger because we have now 17 protons. I'm going to move this guy again. He can hang out down here. We have 17 protons, and we're going to start to fill those valence shells. The innermost shell is going to have two electrons in it, so 1, 2. The second valence shell is filled to capacity when it has 8 electrons. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And in our third valence shell, we'll put 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Now what we notice with this atom is that it only needs one more electron before it becomes stable. So it's going to look and try to find as many electrons as it can. It's going to take this one extra electron that's just hanging out. It's going to bring that in to that valence shell. So it's going to fill it into, It's now at capacity and it's stable. But when we look at it, we have 18 electrons and 17 protons, so we now have one extra negative charge. Okay, so the whole atom is going to become negatively charged. We're going to call it an ion. Any charged atom is an ion. And when we look at this, this chlorine, which is now negatively charged, is going to be attracted to the sodium, which is positively charged. And they're going to join together, and they're going to stick together just by those charges, and they're going to hang out create a new compound that we called sodium chloride, or in the case for geology, this is the mineral halite. Ionic bonds are very weak because they're only made by these charges. They can break apart and reform pretty easily. And a good example is if we took a big piece of halite and we put it in a glass and we left the room, came back tomorrow, it would actually dissolve away. The water molecules are going to pull the sodium and chlorine apart, and they're going to go back into solution. If we leave that glass of very salty water now sitting out overnight for a couple days, maybe a week, and we let the water evaporate, the sodium and chlorine will then start to reform as the water evaporates away, and we'll be left behind with more halite or salt at the bottom of the glass after all the water has evaporated away. So that's ionic bonding.